CTE stands for Common Table Expressions, and in our today's video, we are going to talk about CTEs in MySQL. So hello everyone, and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain, and as we discussed, today we are going to talk about Common Table Expressions. Common Table Expressions, or CTE, they allow us to create queries in multiple tables, which is temporary in that particular query, and then we can utilize it to get more data. Before we start the video, if you want to become a successful data analyst with WsCube, then WsCube Tech is bringing their premium data analytics mentorship program. Its cohort 2 is launching in September. So if you want to be a part of this journey with WsCube, then click on apply now. Now let's get started, guys. For example, let's say in our subquery section, we have talked about this particular query where we got our data something like this. If you remember, this is how our data would look like if I run this, that I have basically products and product names, and based on that I have their order details with quantity ordered and their sum, which is grouped by the product name. For this I have utilized a simple query that I have selected products dot product name, also their quantity ordered from products, and I have joined them with the order details by utilizing product code from both the tables. Now I have grouped by them by using product name. So this is my one query. What if I want to convert it to a table that is temporary in this particular query? For that I can utilize common table expression. I can start with A as and call it a table. I simply need to do this, and what it will do, it will convert this table as A, and now from this A table I can call anything. Like for example, from here I want to call product names, so I'll simply call product name from A limit 5. If I run this, I'll get the top 5 product names over here, which you can see based on the data that was given over here. Okay, so this is how our query works. And if you want to order it by the orders as well, order by orders in descending order, and then put a limit of 5, you'll get the top 5 products with the highest of orders. So this is how you can utilize the common table expression, where you can create a table or a query, call it a table, and from that table you can utilize any columns as you want. For example, let's say for each customer I want to find how much of sales they have given us, at the same time how much amount they have paid, like how much of the sales they have given us will be here in order details. As you can see, in order details we have quantity and price each of each order number, and this order number from the orders is now connected with customer number, and customer numbers is in customers table. So what I basically want, that I want customers sales, basically that how much sales that person has given us. In order to do so, I'll say that select from the customers table I want the customer name, comma, and from the order details table what I simply want is the quantity ordered multiplied by order details dot price each. That means price of each product. Okay, what I basically also want is the sum of it. So let's put a sum over here. And from our first table is customers. Because customers do not have a direct join to order details, it has a direct join to orders, and then orders has a join to order details. We'll join orders with it on customer dot customer number, which will be equal to orders dot customer number, but also we'll join order details to this particular table on. Now the common columns are between order details and orders. So orders dot order number, which is equal to order details dot order number. Now once I do this and put a group by over here as well, that group this data based on customer name and run this. Okay. This is how my output would look like, that here we have customer name, here we have sum of all our values, right? That how much of the total sales this particular customer has given us in total, right? Also, let's call this column as sales. Now, you know that the value of our payments lies in the payments column, where we have a direct join to customer number, that is our payments over here, and this is the amount they have paid. So basically, what I want is that payment should also reflect in one of the columns. In order to do so, what I'll say, I'll also call payments dot amount, okay, and also their sum, right? Sum of payments dot amount. And now we can join another table over here, that join payments. How do we join payments who have a common column with payments? The customer table, right? So we'll join payments by saying that payments dot customer number should be equal to customers dot customer number, and also put on over here. Yeah. So now we have the values, and now if I run it, there might be some issue. Let me just check. Customers dot customer number. Okay, the spelling here. Okay, let me run and see the output. See, let me also give the name to this particular column of payments as payments only. Okay, so this is the customer name, this is the sales that person has given, and this is the payment we have received. Something is weird over here. What we can see is Atlaya Graphic has bought a product of 66,000. 943, but has given a payment of 156,000. Does it make sense to you that if you buy something worth 500 and then you pay 1000 rupees for it, doesn't make any sense? And there are several such instances over here. For example, this Land of Toys, they have bought a product total product of 447,000, while they have paid 527,000. Actually, it is 52,74,000, which is actually a lot. Okay, doesn't make any sense here as well. So what is wrong over here is basically the many-to-many relationship. What many-to-many relationship? That customers has a unique identity of customer number. It has a unique column called as customer number, which is unique for it, right? If I go to orders, these customer numbers over here are repeating 103, 103, 103, 112, 112, 112. 114 has placed orders 5 times, and that's why 5 times its name is reflecting. When we come to payments and arrange our data again in the ascending order, 3 times payments, 3 times payments, and 4 time payment. That means one time this particular customer has not paid, right? So because of the many to many relationship between our data, it is not giving us the correct output. So how do we get the correct output over here? Well, pretty simple. Remove the payments from here, okay. Also remove the join with the payments. This is the data that we have as of now. This is the data that we have of our sales. If I run it, this is sales. Let's call it as table sales, okay. With S as this is our sales table. Similarly, let's call our payments table as well, okay. B as let's put a comma over here because we want to create another subquery. This query, what this query will be basically, let me write it. First of all, let me write it for you so that I can show it to you. This will be nothing but if I say select customer dot customer name comma, we are also looking for the payments that they have made. So we'll say that in the payments table, we have a column called as amount. I want their sum. So basically, we are writing two separate queries over here, calling them a CTE, and then calling one single query which will call the customer name from first table, the sales from the first table, and the payments from the second table, so that our mapping is done properly. Sum from payments join customers on payments dot customer number is equal to customers dot customer number. Okay, group by customers name. Okay. Let's call this as payments. If I run this, this is the customer and this is the payment they have made. Now, let's give it a name. Okay. Let's close it inside the bracket. Put a comma over here because we are creating a second CTE that B as. We don't have to write with again and again. We can simply write B is this. Now, we can say that from A table, we want the customer name, comma. From A table, we also want the sales. From B table, we want the payments. From A, join B on A dot customer name is equal to B dot customer name. With B dot customer name, and we can join both of them. So once we have joined both of them with the common columns over here, so when I run this, this is not the output. Okay, all right. So the name of the table is not A and B but S and B. So let me call it S from here, from S table join the B table, from S call this, and now let's run it. So basically you can see the output now that here we have the customer name, here we have the sales, here we have the payments. You can also find the difference between them in order to check if there is any pending amount. For example, here we can see that this particular customer, La Rochelle Gifts, has made a sales of 1,58,573, but the amount that we have received is only 1,16,000. So now you can also do over here, you can put a comma and say S dot sales minus B dot payments, and let's call this as pending amount. Pending. Okay, let's call it as pending only. So now we can get the pending amount as well over here. You can see here we have sales, here we have payments, here we have the pending amount. Why we couldn't write a single query is just because of the many-to-many relationship over here between our customer number and customer number. The customer in order table is coming many times, and also the customer number in the payment tables is coming many times. Due to that relationship, we could not create a query in a single table. But what we did instead, we have utilized common table expressions over here in order to create one table with the sales data, the other table with the payments data, and then we have joined them together in order to retrieve this particular data, which is nothing but the name of the customer, the sales they have made, the payment we have received, and the amount that is pending. So I hope the CTE part is pretty much clear. How and where we can utilize it is also clear. And for more such tech related videos, subscribe to our channel WsCube Tech. Thank you.